This is the HSE Developer News of February 8, 2024. Hey everyone, I welcome you all to this special edition of SAP Developer News. Today's episode is exclusively by the Women Developer Advocates to promote International Women and Girls Day in Science. Stay tuned for another episode coming up on February 11th, where we share our experiences in the roundtable discussions to celebrate the event. The January 2024 release of the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model is out. The release notes in the CAP documentation cover everything you need to know. Here are some highlights from this release. There's a new CDS plugin that supports telemetry, including automatic open telemetry instrumentation. It's super simple to use. You should try it out today. You can now define an event as a projection on a remote entity, super useful when importing and integrating external services. There are improvements in the way large binary data is returned, which also is important in serving media data. CAP Java now supports Cloud SDK version 5, and you should migrate as soon as possible. There are also features such as the ability to defer emitting events until you're ready, sorting improvements for lean drafts, and much more. Check out the release notes linked in the description for detailed information. Also, there's a new website that helps us celebrate and explore the growing selections of packages for CAP Node.js. This is especially interesting in the context of the relatively new CDS plugin concept and the growing availability of CAP Core and open source packages. Head over to bestofcapjs.org and check out what's hot, what's new, and even add your own package. Hello, everyone. On January 31, 2024, SAP announced the launch of a new guided premium learning offering through SAP Learning Hub, accompanied by an enhanced certification program, including a new role-based certification of SAP S/4HANA Cloud Public Edition. The enhanced SAP Learning Hub provides subscribers with access to high-quality content and allows 4 certification attempts per learner per year with expert guidance in digital live sessions, on-demand hands-on practice systems, advanced analytics, and learning management functionalities. The SAP Learning Hub Partner Edition has tailored learning experiences with curated learning journeys, exclusive access to events and subject matter experts at a significantly reduced price per user per year. You also get additional chances to earn certifications along with improved analysis and tracking features. As the tech world moves towards cloud adoption, the enhanced SAP Learning Hub and the new certification program aim to help customers and partners navigate the challenges of a tight labor market and the necessary workforce transformation. For those of you looking to grow their skills and future-proof their careers, we recommend to take advantage of this opportunity and learn for free, anywhere, anytime. Check out the below links for more information and happy learning. Thank you. Hey SAP developers, for those of you working in RESTful Application Programming Model or in common term RAP, let me share you a hidden treasure that can come in handy. ABAP keyword documentation provides a list of all available language elements of the RAP behavior definition language and their release dates. This allows you to easily look up for the features of each RAP BO implementation type and find out whether they're available in your current product release. The table covers the full scope of the RAP BDL, including all statements for managed and unmanaged RAP BOs, RAP BO interfaces, service projections, BDF extensions, and even abstract behavior definitions. Andrea's blog post provides the link to the table in ABAP keyword documentation, seems like a helpful guide. Kindly check it out. Hello everyone. We are thrilled to announce that the monthly developer challenge is back. As many of you are aware, developer challenges are short, engaging, beginner-level puzzles designed to encourage you to explore and acquire knowledge on new topics. The focus for February 2024 challenge will be SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, CAP, and its plugins. CAP plugins are extensions to the CAP framework that enable developers to enhance the capabilities of their CAP-based applications. You can embark on this journey along with us every Wednesday for the next 4 weeks and build a simple CAP application and integrate a new plugin into this application every week. To join the challenge, simply post a screenshot of your solution as a reply to the discussion in this link. We look forward to seeing your innovative approaches and solutions. Good luck.
Hello, everybody. Hope you are all doing great. I would like to highlight the two key features in the latest release of SAP Build Apps. We are all aware of the Visual Cloud Function capability, using which we can visually design and deploy application backend for the frontend created using SAP Build Apps. It's a very powerful capability enabling the full stack development. Coming to the feature updates, number one, SAP has now added role-based user authorization to these Visual Cloud Function projects to enhance the governance capabilities. A system administrator or a developer can create user roles and assign specific permissions to make the applications more secure. Number two, for the application frontend that is built using SAP Build Apps, if it is linked to a backend project that is created using Visual Cloud Function, now there is a simplified method to embed this complete stack into the SAP Build work zone. To get started with this feature, Identity Authentication Service Tenant can be enabled in SAP Build Work Zone. If you would like to learn more about these updates, please check out the blog post by our product expert, Esme Xavier, explaining these features and their enablement approach. Link to the blog post is in the description below. Thank you.